These are the times when I think life and technology is trying their best to make books obsolete. But I don't think this effort will ever be successful. We must thank those people particularly who are writing books nowadays and books for the children. As a matter of fact, these are the times when personalities are formed, when the mind is growing. And no audiovisual can ever be the substitute of a book. We have television, we have channels for the children, we have cartoons and so on and so forth. But the moment audiovisual is provided to a child, the menu is fixed. There is no participation of the viewer. Everything is given. But when the same child reads a storybook, the child fantasizes, imagines. He or she makes his own palaces, own jungles, makes the form of the prince and the princess, their faces. They are made in the imagination of the child. And that is how the child learns to imagine, to fantasize, to think, which is not possible with audiovisual. For an imaginative, wholesome personality of a child, good children's literature is inevitable. And anybody who is contributing towards it should be thanked. Thank you. I have not read the book. As a matter of fact, I have just seen it inside the covers. So, all I can say about that book, I'll quote Abraham Lincoln. अब्राहम लिंकन के पास कोई साहब आए एक बुक लेके कह ले आप तो प्रेसिडेंट ऑफ अमेरिका हैं आपके पास कहाँ टाइम है कि आप किताब मेरी पढ़ेंगे लेकिन अगर इसके बारे में खुद लिख देते तो बड़ा अच्छा था तो अब उसने किताब ही नहीं पढ़ी थी क्या लिखता तो उसने बड़ी अच्छी बात लिखी उसने लिखा कि जो लोग ऐसी किताबें पसंद करते हैं जैसी कि ये किताब है वो इस किताब को बिल्कुल वैसी ही पाएंगे जैसी किताबें वो पसंद At the moment, I am in the position to say only this. But I'm sure, knowing her, she's an extremely bright young lady, and I'm sure that she must have written a good book. As a matter of fact, actually, I'm feeling that I'm quite unnecessary because it seems to be an extremely self-sufficient family. With such articulate daughter and such articulate husband, I don't think she needs any other recommendation. They are doing fine. So, thank you very much. Once again, congratulations and all the best wishes. Thank you.
Every time he speaks, we get to learn something new. Every time it's something new and something to ruminate about. So, we will ruminate about it. But your compliments in the end were quite interesting as well. Are wonderful, but maybe some pearls of wisdom would be nice as well.
Good evening, everybody. Congratulations, Pooja, Samir, Alkaji, family, daughter, on this wonderful occasion. And a very happy new year to all of you.
Yes.
So, kitabon ke bare mein baat hai. To read or not to read? That is a silly question. Reading is to the mind what exercise is to the body. There are many, many ways to enlarge your children's world. The love of books, reading books, is the best one of them all. And so to that extent, I would say, I just received the book yesterday. I just came into town and I received the book from Samir. And आई वॉन्टेड टू नो कि भाई किताब में क्या है तो मैं भी जरा पढ़ लूँ. सो आई डिड गो थ्रू अबाउट 20-30 पेजेस ऑफ द बिगिनिंग एंड आई रियली इट टुक मी बैक ऑलमोस्ट टू माई चाइल्डहुड व्हेन आई वाज लाइक 10, 11, 12 एंड आई रीड ऑल दीज बुक्स व्हिच हैड लाइक पूजा'स बुक हैज एडवेंचर एक्साइटमेंट इनोसेंस एंड जॉय. And I'm so happy, Pooja. Had I had it a little earlier, I would have read possibly the whole book because I found it very engaging. It really was. I mean, I wanted to know आगे क्या होने वाला है because it's about this little bunch of children going to the woods and then what they find there. And yes, the thought did come to my mind. I have a 13-year-old daughter, and I was like, I think I'll give this to Janvi. I think she's going to enjoy this book. So yes, I'm sure all little young, I think this is more like 9, 10-year-olds and 12-year-olds and 13-year-olds and 14-year-olds, all these young children will definitely enjoy The Curse of the Windwoods. So congratulations, Pooja, and wish all these little children who are going to read this a happy reading.
Thank you.
Now like to call the person who has probably contributed to the book more than anybody else besides Pooja, of course, Professor Mrinal Meeri, my father-in-law. Now, please.
Thank you very much, Sameer. Javed ji, Mohit ji, Arita, Pooja, and friends. But I'm a little bit torn. Standing here in front of all these cameras. I've never faced so many cameras. And I know they're not for me, but nonetheless, they're there staring at me. I'm also a little bit daunted in the presence of celebrities. thanks to Pooja. Thanks to Sameer. I have this tremendous opportunity to stand here, share stage with people like who are here seated, and say a few words. You know, Pooja is my daughter. She has grown up with me. And I know her perhaps better than most people. And one thing, you know, there'll be all kinds of things. Garima has told you about the inspiration behind the story that Pooja has had. And not just one inspiration, but several inspirations. But I think this one thing that has led Pooja to the writing of the story of the sky is a quality of character which is there in most people, but in her it is extremely pronounced. It is the earth quality of character which gives you the urge to see things, to look at things, to find things behind the face. And many people have this problem. In Pooja, it is a benign interest in what is behind the face. And many people have this interest, but not so benign. In her case, it is always benign, always full of sympathy, always free. And it is this, I think, which really is behind her effort to find a medium for expressing her feeling about the world. And coming to the story is, it is, you have this bunch of boys and girls.
Computers.
Again, the same urge to know what is going on. behind each of these stories faced, and to prove, and each of these boys and girls, they are endowed with the virtue which is different from the virtue that the other person, other boy girl has. And one of them is, has courage of faith, virtue. Another has honesty of faith. A third one has great sensitivity and intelligence. A fourth one has great perseverance. And so on. And all these virtues come together. And it is like in a human being, if all these virtues come together, you have a fantastic person. And in this book, these virtues come together in this boys and girls. And you have a great team. And a team which is, again, you know, there is so much love, so much friendship, so much care for each other. And at the same time, there is this very, very intelligent, very, very penetrating kind of probing into what is going on. And the story itself. So I think this is how I look at the book. I hope Pooja will carry on with this, you know, urge to write. She will probably explore other modes of writing. She will probably look at other ways of expressing the, you know, the her ideas about the world, her ideas about people, her ideas about friends, her perspective. I think that is great. So thank you very much.
You know, look up to them because the world needs it. You know, in this fast-moving world, all these qualities in human beings is something that we should constantly look out for. Thank you, and I'd like to now call upon my sister, who will speak about the book, or as usually she does, perhaps sing a song. So I think whatever she does, she should come up and do it.
This is the first time in my life I'm in front of a mic and I have to talk about a book. But yeah, the person concerned is very dear to me and to our entire family. I've always found Pooja very, very curious about everything. She wants to know what goes on behind the minds of people, and whenever we go to an event or anything, whoever's sitting next to us, she starts asking questions. In fact, I have to keep telling her, stop it, stop it. Don't ask more questions. She says, I'm interested in people and what they think and what's going on in their mind and what they're doing. And so as a result, when we go somewhere together, I always said to people, and I said, "Wahan pe zyada kisi se sawal hua tha, puchna please." So I think that's a writer in her that is, you know, wants to know the human mind and what goes on. This book is a fiction, and I'm basically a person who likes fiction. I like to live in a dream world. I like fantasy, I like imagination. I don't like to read real stuff. I like to, you know, really read fiction and then imagine things on my own and sort of visualize what it would be like, what it would look like. And I think Pooja and myself, we both are very, we really love Agatha Christie and her style of writing. And I think in her book, she has a bit of, she's inspired by that style and influenced also maybe a little. I haven't read the entire book yet, but I know that she must have written a brilliant book. And when we as a family want to encourage her, she is a little low profile, doesn't want to really come out in the open. But I think this time is the first time we are really sort of going out to encourage her and to make sure that her books reach the audience, reach children, reach people. And I really I really hope she continues to write and come out with some more romantic novels, as well as adult suspense, adult mysteries. So all my love and blessings are with her. And give your blessings with her. Thank you.
Thank you. There have been a lot of accusations about the fact that nobody has read the book. Well, it's not a surprise, it's just come out, right, literally 2 days back. And my nephew here, he's hand carried it with his own hand. So it's available here, it's available as Jayco Distributors, it's published by Liffey, it will be out there in the retail stores. I'm not going to start a sales pitch here, but if you can go grab a book, it will be great if you can read it as well. So finally, sorry? And we have some books here as well, in case anybody wants to pick up a book. Yeah, it's fine. Bhavna ji.
Good evening, everybody. I'd first like to start by thanking everybody. I know people do it at the end, but I'd like to do it in the beginning. So, Chavit ji, I won't say anything about him, except that we all, our family, is very fortunate to be able to refer to him as our dear friend. And Juhi, of course, she's such a super talented artist. And someone who I personally have always admired because of the grace and dignity with which she conducts herself. That's very inspiring. And I think it's a lovely role model for young women and children. So that's my daughter. And the eminent educationist and member of parliament, Professor Mary, who is my father. And the legendary Nightingale, Alka ji, who's my lady. It's so wonderful, and all you ladies and gentlemen of the press, and my dear friends, all of you who have actually taken the time out to come here and be here and support me, and I really appreciate that. So first, thank you everybody for being here, and the children for putting all this up for us, and Sameer for bringing all you wonderful people together. So that is very important. The Curse of the Windhoods is a book written as a sort of a tribute, to all the great writers of classical adventure stories. So books that I have grown up reading, and as Julie said, it took her back to childhood, and books we all used to read. And that it was designed to do that, because I find that these writers were so talented and so wonderful that they took you into their world. You opened a page and you lost yourself. You forgot your stresses, you forgot your tensions or the chores that you lined up, and you just curl up and you just you'd be happy for a while. So I thought that it would be wonderful to maybe point the young people of today in that direction, because they are brought up in the world of the internet, and they've got such fast lives, they've got so much on their plate with homework and with tuition. And so I thought that maybe we can, you know, like George Bernard Shaw once said, that make it a rule never to refer a child to a book that you yourself would not read. So I really feel that it's something I identify with. So you know, when I go to a bookshop, I invariably end up near the adventure section and with an Agatha Christie and or an Enid Blyton, and I'm thinking, oh, only there was one book that I hadn't read. If I could just find that one, it was like, it's like a treasure to me. So I thought that, okay, let me write something as a tribute to these great writers. So if these young children can sit down and enjoy my book, maybe a hot cup of chocolate, a comfortable sofa, and they read my book for an hour or two, then there's nothing more I would ask. So I'll end with that. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Comment on the book by the author, definitely. But before that, what is interesting is that when you become friends with one person, then how you gain a full family. I met Alka Yagnik when I was traveling with her for a tour to America. Observed her, wrote about her. Through Alka, I met Alka's mother, brother, bhabhi, then daughter Gargi was having something in her college. She invited me. And Gargi's, sorry, Garima. I always make her garbage with the name, so you have to forgive me. I'm old. Garima and Garima's friends, and today I come for this book release.
Pooja has always talked about her book to me, about writing, what she goes through, what she wants to write, and we have had long conversations, and there was nobody to stop her. That's why she's asking so many questions. She's allowed. It's fine. I wish you all the best. I can understand what you're going. I said no as a co-author. I have to support because this is a moment. We want all your friends and.
Apart from reading, I think I used to read a lot of comics. शायद तो अगर आप इन्फ्लुएंस बोलते तो अगर मेरे को थोड़ी सी कॉमेडी आ गई शायद वो कॉमिक्स की वजह से आई
सो
मैं although I don't have the moral right because it is Shabana speaker, but it's interesting. Shabana in her school, she told me herself, she used to read Anne Blyton and her friend used to read Anne Blyton. And she had convinced her friend when she was 9 or 10 years old that actually she is George. And on every Saturday, she flies down to New York and for 2 days she lived with her aunt and obviously the aunt is Anne Blyton. And but she doesn't want to tell anybody and she has told the aunt that don't you ever tell that I'm George. So that is why instead of giving the name Shabana, aunt is kind enough to cover up for her and give this name George. So that shows, I mean, a child's imagination and such fibers in the child don't become actors when they grow up.
Jogi ji? Jogi ji here, towards your left. Is there a writer hidden inside you and would you ever like to write a book yourself?
Jogi ji, Hindi mein bolega please.
Hindi mein. Writer mere paas baithe.
आप में कोई राइटर
और मेरे में अंदर कहीं से जाग जाएगा मे बी आफ्टर टुनाइट आई विल थिंक अबाउट इट नहीं बट इफ आई एवर डू मे बी माय ऑटोबायोग्राफी दैट इज व्हाट आई विल राइट
तो कब आ सकती है अगर
अरे भाई अभी जिंदगी बहुत है बाकी
Also, one more question. You know, we met Aamir Khan last week. He said that he would be calling you to discuss the issues that you have with PK. So, has he called you yet?
भई आप संदेशा लेकर आए हैं. बस जैसे ही उनका कॉल आएगा, मैं पहले आपको बताऊंगी.
But issues क्या हैं, जूही जी? Issues कुछ बताएंगे मतलब?
ये पूजा की किताब.
हम पूजा से भी सवाल करेंगे. आप बट आप अगर बता देंगे तो काफी अच्छा होता है. मतलब क्या issues हैं वो?
आप ट्विटर पे बहुत ध्यान रखते हैं
आपका फैन फॉलोइंग इतना ज़्यादा
है थैंक यू वी कम बैक टू द सब्जेक्ट ऑफ टुनाइट्स इवेंट
पूजा
हाउ लॉन्ग यू टुक टू राइट एंड हाउ वर यू राइटिंग वर यू राइटिंग योर जॉब ऑन द कंप्यूटर ऑन द पेपर आई थिंक अ कपल ऑफ
इयर्स अ कपल ऑफ इयर्स And it, I wrote most of it in Tamil, actually. And you know the environment, the countryside, and I'm a very a person. I love nature, and I love old things. So I love old buildings and old gardens and leaves, everything. So I think I was inspired a lot by the beauty of the UK, and of course my absolute love for classic adventure stories. So that problem, I did. Also, yeah, I wrote on paper. I'm a very untidy writer. I scroll and I sort of scratch it out and I go, you know. And I think a lot of the mind of children, they're of course we all know they're very pure because they have not learned how to connive. They haven't learned negativity. Life hasn't also taught them that. Harder lessons. So their minds are so alert, so bright, so intelligent. And I love the story of Shabanaji that Javiji said about she's George. And I think somewhere that thing is there in most children.
It is registered.
Yes. So yeah, so that inspires me. You know, the mind, somewhere, yes, that did inspire me. That children will get into a book and then they lose themselves in different characters. And yeah, in my book, I think what's more important is the personality type than anything else. So the atmosphere, yes, it's very romantic in a large sense of the word. It's there's a lot to do with the scenic beauty and but I think more it is the personality test and the interaction between these children.
Thanks.
Thank you
so much.
Alka, I would like to ask a question here. Alka, yeah. This is a wholesome family where Pooja is a writer, Alka is a singer. May I take the opportunity of asking whose quality have you inherited and whose quality has she inherited out of the two, mom and dad?
Well, I have obviously inherited it from my mom. Music has been in the family. She's been a classical singer, and we have music in the blood. And not only me, I'm a professional singer, but my brother sings beautifully as well, although it's just a hobby with him. My niece Garima sings beautifully, and Devej also, he plays the instrument and he sings. So it's there, it's there. It's come from my mom. And of course, my dad used to also sing very well. And he used to sing on the high notes. So he used to always say ki tumhara talent to mummy se aaya, lekin tumhari jo uncha jo gaati ho range hai wo mere se aaya. He used to always say that. So Pooja, of course, I think from her parents, from Pooja, would you like to say?
Yeah, my parents are great writers, really. But of course, I write very different things from them. I write fiction, and they write about philosophy. They're great philosophers, and they write about philosophy. And my mother likes to research the Northeast and the old stories and legends of the Northeast. So yes, writing is definitely in my blood.
Javed sir, one question. Javed sir, you achieved a personal milestone last year, 50 years in Indian cinema, Bollywood. So how does it feel, sir? And is there anything left to achieve for you this year, which
you almost everything. As a matter of fact, I mean, 50 years don't mean at all that I have achieved everything. There's so much to do in life. And as a matter of fact, when I see the work of other people and how wonderful work they are doing, I mean, including VK, the kind of scripts they are writing. So I get very, very, very impressed and inspired, as a matter of fact. So I would like to write some good scripts again. And again, in inverted commas.
Will it be in 2015?
Hopefully, hopefully. And more poetry, more lyrics, and better poetry, better lyrics, better scripts. So, I mean, there's so much to do.
Thank you. There's one question from the younger audience we'd like to divert the microphone to. Raise your voice.
I have kind of two sort of interrelated questions for the author.
Michael. Okay, we'll limit it to another two questions and then we'll...
Nalin ji, aa jayenge.
Listen, why don't
you start? We'll do a line and then
come, come, come.
Garima, go.
एक दिन आप यूं हमको मिल जाएंगे, फूल ही फूल राहों में खिल जाएंगे. मैंने सोचा न था दम दम तड़म एक दिन जिंदगी इतनी होगी हंसी, झूमेगा आसमां गाएगी जमी. मैंने सोचा न था, मैंने सोचा न था.
One of my favorite songs. I'm so glad you thought
mine
of
mine too, and composer and the lyricist are right here. Oh,
neighbor.
Yeah, we'll travel, we'll... Arin. Arin.
Okay. So, growing up, this is one of my favorite movies in the entire world. And the song, if anybody's seen, is the like cutest, I mean, most like fun picturization in the world. And Juhi ji has this like one step in this song, like that. It was really cute and I kept doing it when I was younger. I was always like, and yeah, so I'll sing just a little bit of that.
Ek shararat hone ko hai,
एक कयामत होने को है, एक होश हमारे होने को है, हमको मोहब्बत होने को है। लाए 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 लाए
Do you know what is common between these two songs?
Thank you. Thank you all for coming. Enjoy your evening. Right? Thank you so much.
दूर रह भाई।
अरे तू पकड़ ले अपना।
पकड़ ले यार ये। इसका भी पकड़ ले।
यार
ये सबसे पहले तो आज के दिन लॉन्च के बाद जाना चाहिए।
अलका जी की और उस पर हबी हबी की किताब की लिखी हुई किताब द कंसर्न ऑफ विद उसका लॉन्च था। सॉरी
डोंट डू दिस प्लीज। थोड़ा पीछे रखिए,
मतलब नीचे रखिए क्योंकि ओके सो
यार कम ऑन
दिख रहे ना।
ने एक किताब लिखी है द कर्स ऑफ द विंडवुड्स, एडवेंचर स्टोरी है बच्चों की, तो आज उसका लॉन्च हो रहा था एंड दैट्स व्हाई मैं यहां पर आई।
अच्छा आप कितना बुक पढ़ना पसंद करते हो या फिर कोई बचपन की मेमोरीज जो आप हमारे साथ शेयर करना चाहते हैं?
ये कहूँगी कि बचपन में मैंने ज़्यादा किताबें पढ़ी थी, अब थोड़ा पढ़ना कम हो रहा है। हाँ और बचपन में मैं ऐसी ही कुछ किताबें पढ़ती थी इन इट लाइटन्स, जिनमें बच्चे होते थे, बदमाश भी होते थे, अच्छे भी होते थे, उनका ग्रुप होता था और उनके वो कहीं स्कूल से जाते थे या स्कूल में मस्ती करते थे या बाहर जाते थे तो उनके साथ कोई यू नो एडवेंचर हो जाती थी। एंड आई ऑलवेज वॉन्टेड कि मेरा ऐसा ग्रुप हो, मेरे साथ भी ऐसा कुछ हो स्कूल में। So you always wanted that and I think very similar aise hi kuch kahani